Hi friends. Welcome to a new learning video on Pharmaguideline. Today we will discuss the regulatory expectations for cleaning validation. Cleaning validation is an integral part of the pharmaceutical manufacturing process. A piece of equipment itself can contaminate the product if it is not cleaned properly. Improperly cleaned manufacturing equipment is a major source of cross-contamination. Regulatory agencies are more concerned about the cross-contamination of penicillin with non-penicillin products. A number of warning letters have been issued by the FDA for deficiencies in cleaning procedures. Residues of the previous product, as well as the cleaning agent used for equipment cleaning, must be cleaned to prevent cross-contamination. There are some general requirements of regulatory agencies for pharmaceutical manufacturing firms regarding cleaning validation. Let us know them one by one. A written procedure for cleaning processes for all pieces of equipment should be used in manufacturing. If there are different cleaning procedures for a batch-to-batch change and product-to-product change or water-soluble and water-insoluble residues, then conditions to follow the procedures should be clearly mentioned. Fluid bed dryer bags are difficult to clean, so they should be dedicated to specific products. Cleaning validation protocol should be written and approved before starting the validation activity. Responsibilities for the validation activity, sampling procedure, analytical method, acceptance criteria and revalidation criteria must be clearly defined in the validation protocol. Validation must be conducted in accordance with the validation protocol. Every written step must be followed and each followed step must be written in the protocol. The final report must be approved by the management with the result and conclusion of the cleaning validation activity. The conclusion should state that the residues of the previous product have been reduced to the acceptance level. During an inspection, the regulatory inspectors need to be satisfied with the cleaning process and its validation. Validation should answer their question during evaluation, like how the equipment is cleaned, with a scrubber or just washed with water. Was cleaning batch to batch or product to product? Which parts of the equipment were cleaned? These steps can help to develop an effective and easy procedure to clean the equipment, because cleaning validation is not required between two batches of the same product, and the equipment should be only visually clean in that condition. Some clean-in-place systems and equipment are difficult to clean, and the operators must be aware of the cleaning of these difficult-to-clean parts of the system and equipment. Microbial aspects of the clean-in-place systems and equipment should be considered, because microbial growth may occur during storage of the equipment and systems. Equipment should be properly dried after cleaning, and application of 70% IPA solution may help to prevent microbial growth during storage. A maximum storage period must be defined within which the equipment or system can be used for manufacturing. If any residue is found on the cleaned equipment, then it is necessary to review the cleaning procedure, and the operator who cleaned the equipment should be trained again for proper cleaning. The specificity and sensitivity of the analytical method must be determined. HPLC can help to determine the contaminants at a very low level. If it is not possible to determine the contaminants, it doesn't prove the absence of contaminants at all, but it indicates the analytical is unable to detect the contaminants below its detection limit. All contaminants present on the equipment surface can't be recovered, therefore a recovery test must be carried out to get accurate results. An inaccurate recovery factor may result in false cleaning validation. Both direct surface sampling and rinse sampling are required for cleaning validation. Interference of the swab in the analysis should be determined. Surface sampling is important because water and soluble residues and dried and hard to clean areas of the equipment can be sampled easily using this technique. By using of rinse sampling technique, the inaccessible parts of equipment and systems can be sampled. A large surface area is sampled by rinse sampling, therefore, a very low amount of the residue can be sampled and determined. Limits for cleaning validation should be established on the basis of the therapeutic dose of the product, and established limits should be practical, achievable and justifiable. Detergents used for cleaning must be cleaned completely. Residues of detergent are also considered contaminants because detergent is not a part of the product. To analyze the residues of detergent, all components of detergent must be known, therefore detergents for cleaning should be selected carefully. It is necessary to fulfill the regulatory requirements to prevent the warning letter. Like and share this video with your friends and colleagues. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and also hit the bell icon to get regular updates. Thanks for watching this video.